SAS 9 system evaluation is a tool delivered with content assessment, and it's designed to help a customer prepare for an update in place of SAS 9.4. It's downloadable from support.sas.com, and basically what it does is it examines a SAS deployment to look for possible issues that could adversely impact updating from one release of SAS 9.4 to another. In this demo, we will run system evaluation on a SAS 9 system and review the results of the evaluation. System evaluation should be run before any update in place of a SAS 9.4 environment. It should be run using the SAS install account and on each machine in the deployment which has a configuration directory. On the demo, we'll run system evaluation on a SAS 9.4 system that is a single tier on Linux. Let's get started with the demo. It doesn't take much configuration to get going with system evaluation. We need to edit two files. The first one, meta-parms.sas, contains the connection information to the SAS 9 metadata server. We want to enter a customer and a label for the tier that we're running on, and then it's basically the connection information, so the host, the port, the user ID and password, and it should be user ID and password of an unrestricted user. The other file is the setenv.yaml, which has a lot of attributes, but only really two that matter to system evaluation. There's the location of the SAS 9 configuration directory and the location of the SAS 9 home directory. So with those two complete, we can go ahead and in the directory where we installed it, we can run system evaluation by typing /system evaluation and kick it off. The tool will run and it will tell you in the window what it's doing as it goes through the process. You'll see each of the steps being documented, and it doesn't take too long to run, so we'll let it run and we'll pick up again when it completes. When the process is done, we should get some notes at the bottom that's going to tell us where it's writing the logs files to and where the results are. And the results are in the install directory of the content assessment tool, which includes system evaluation. So let's go look at those results inside content assessment, open the results directory, and then the evaluation directory. And within the evaluation directory, we see a directory for the label we chose for this tier, and the summary reports are within there. I'm going to look at the summary report first. At the top, we get details about the system that we ran system evaluation on. The configuration directory, the operating system, some hardware details, and some information about the kernel of Linux it's running on. The main information to pay attention to here, though, is the number of issues that have been identified. And we can see in this report we have a total of 6 issues. So if we scroll down, we'll be able to see some of those issues. Firstly, here we see we have in this release some products that have been retired, so BI portlets and SAS information delivery portal, and a recommendation to go look at the documentation links. We'll take a look at those in a second. They're at the very top of the report. If we go down a little further, we probably see some more issues appearing. Yeah, we can see an issue here about the Gempire setting timeout property and a recommendation to change it. Some issues identified in the SAS logs with the SAS 9 case log check. And another couple of issues about SAS web infrastructure platform data server and some changes to configuration we might want to make there. These are changes to the infrastructure data server that are going to make it more likely that your update in place of SAS 9.4 will succeed. So if I scroll back up to the top, we will see under helpful links, documentation about the different issues that we've encountered and what we might need to do in the source environment to give us a better chance of updating this environment to the latest release of SAS 9.4. Something to pay attention to closely is the operating system that we're running on. There were some operating systems went out of support, and there's a link here to the supported operating systems. If we click on that link, we get documentation about what operating systems are supported for each different release of SAS. And as I said, with 9.4M8, there was some Linux operating systems went out of support. In this page, we can navigate to the SAS release and the operating system we're interested in. And if we select the platform and then the operating system, in our case, Linux 64-bit. If we select that and click Submit, then below we will see all the supported operating systems for SAS 9.4M8. And then if we want to go over to our environment, we can compare that to what operating system our environment's running on. We go to a command prompt there and do a cat of the etc OS release file. We can see that we're running CentOS 7, so we can compare that to the report that we saw based on what operating systems are supported for 9.4M8. If we return to the directory where the reports are located, there's one other report. We've looked at the summary report. There's also a topology report. And if I open that topology report, that basically gives us the topology and environment. So what SAS products are installed on this tier and what the version of those SAS products are. And a little bit of information about the license. So that's a demo of system evaluation. We looked at the two reports, the topology report and of course the system evaluation report, which is the main one, which documents any issues that may impact our ability to update to the latest release of SAS 9.4. With the helpful documentation links on how to make changes to your SAS 9.4 environment to ensure you have a successful update process.